Oh, this is Sammy School 2, and I'm giving you another episode of Europa Universalis. Now, I've been about 20 minutes into Sargon of Akkad's Confessions of a Game Gate, whatever. I mean, the interview's he's done at meetup. I'm still laughing. I'm gonna see if I can get the game finished. You know, at least almost finishing this session. I was going to be going fencing tonight, but it's a bank holiday today. Obviously not when you're watching this, because for one, there's probably nobody watching, but, you know. So usually I'd be at the fencing club, but the club, the people who own the the community center, well, the club is, they shut early because it's a bank holiday. So obviously no fencing tonight, which is really disappointing, really, because it's gonna be harder to get back into it next week. And I've been doing really, really well on my weight, which I'm really, really happy about, seriously. It's like, I've lost about 4 inches already. I say 4 inches, probably a bit exaggerated, no. I've lost a lot of weight. It's like, literally, I can't wear my own clothes now. You know, I have to walk around with my hands in my pockets all the time, or they literally will just fall straight down, because they're not even touching me anymore. I went on a diet, essentially. It's not really a diet. I have been too lazy to eat, and I have been exercising. Jesus Christ. See, I've been exercising a lot. I go to fencing like 2-3 times a week, like, depending on. I don't know. You know, I go to pretty much every session. See, my sister runs the club, so one might as well go. But yeah, so I'm going very regularly. So, you know. And combined with that, I've been exercising at home. So I'm quite proud of myself. Quite proud. Oh, you won't believe what happened. You won't believe this. I have bought a bag of Skittles. Yeah? And I've been eating 4 Skittles. So all I've been eating, because I want to see if I can make the bag last a week. I've done this before. I did it with a packet of Maltesers. I just did a few every day and I managed to make it last an entire week. I've done it with Minstrels as well, but they only lasted 4 days. Dad's gone and eaten them all. He's just gone in and snaffled all of them. I'm really, really, really annoyed. It was heartbreaking, I tell you. It was heartbreaking. No, I didn't really care, but I do care. Because I just really wanted Skittles. There's no fucking Skittles left. You saw my Skittles. I'm Skittles again. So. You see, that's another plus 5 discipline, isn't it? Oh, plus a minus 10%, it's that! And another plus 25%. And, no. Because you see, I've already got, plus 50% and plus 10%. That would give me plus 75%. And it would net me another diplomat. Oh. I would do it dip, you know, but it's a bit obvious what things would be. I could coconut crack it, I suppose. coconut crack. Coconut crack. Yeah, but, fuck it, I'm just gonna. I'm closing my eyes and I'm spinning my mouse around. Okay, it landed close to Sirius Trigaspides. This is not a good way to decide, just so you know. It's like, if you're watching this for advice, first you're in the wrong place, go watch a Roomba. Or DDR Jake. Jesus Christ, Bohemia's in the Emperor. Seriously, you chose Bohemia over Austria. I would have understood Brandenburg, but not Bohemia. Anyway, yes. So as you can imagine, I have not really done much really today. Plus 10%. I'm tempted to ramp up the tariffs. Wait, can I not do that anymore? Can you only do it with events? No. Oh, customize subject. Oh. Ah, yes, I can see. Increase and decrease tariffs. Anyway. You win. Fair enough. So that's finished. You shall be my servant forevermore. Because there's no way in it. See, the big problem usually what you get is of the combined power of all the vassals. And you see relative power. So usually, you know, you'll have tons and tons of all these, you know, shit tons of colonies over here. And eventually you just get to the point where your colonies together are more powerful than you. So they're just like, haha. Okay, you would usually be in Sevilla. How much does it cost to upgrade her? Oh, shit. I'll save up money and then I'll upgrade you. I promise. Now, come on. Oh! Why does that not give a national tax modifier? That really pisses me off. They've done that in the new update, haven't they? Oh, I guess I'll just buy that. So you've invested 40. So. I actually don't give a shit. Okay. So let's continue doing what we were doing before. Which is waiting. Oh my god, I think we can declare war now. Yes! Brunei still hasn't done it. Okay, shitloads. I don't give a shit. Lana! Genius name! I want to get up to 40,000 first though. So first, before anything else, you know, because I don't want to be screwed over, because they're going to come at me with everything they've got. And I'm not going to be able to get anyone across the straits. Let's be honest. Or maybe, actually just send these guys across. What do you think? Oh, this is hard. See, I could just have, you know, an army of 35,000. You know, give the 5,000. Do you think it's what? No. No. I will send them over there anyway, then. Why? Because I'm not going to have a chance to send them over again. Actually, if I'm going to do that, I'm going to do this is what I'm going to do. Now, cameraman, I don't care about. Okay, we'll go like that. Now you go straight up and kick their asses. Good boys. Good lads. Get that goddamn merchantism. Stay here. Because it literally isn't going to take you any time to do that, is it? Are you serious? He's trying to muster up some kind of army. Listen, you sort that out. Oh, my vassals are here. Good boys. You go do all the work. Why is this minus 77? Please win this fight. Come on. Win it in the single. Really? They move away. Okay, you go down there and then come back up to Lemuri. No, our theologian has died. Please tell me there's another theologian. Yes. I love you, Alonso. Alonso de Ojeda. As you may have noticed, I am good at butchering names. Especially Spanish names. That's a lot of money. I love you again. Seriously, love you. Give me a kiss. So. Jesus Christ, this is a lot of trade, fella. I can get. Anyone give me any plus 19? Come on, is there another? Come on, give me another plus 19. It's plus 5. See, ideally, I want something over here, don't I? So I'll grab that. Because I do. We'll raise water taxes. And reduce inflation. Oh, I'm following you to where you're hiding as well. Come on, you're gonna die now. No, I'm going to wait. Because then I won't take out a load. Aha! Now I am no longer going to be forced to have a fucking huge load. And 20,000 men here. Aha, you fools! Pasai is already offering peace. But I shall not accept your terms. Because this fort is being a real nuisance. What level is it? Oh, it's level 3 to stop? Jesus Christ, no wonder it's been such a nuisance. I think you just heard my voice crack again. So, I'm going to take that fort. Literally, I'm going to. It will be my fort. I'm not just going, you know, I'm not going to sort of just, as in take it as in siege it. I'm going to take it as in, we shall now, you know, conquer it. Because it's such a fucking nuisance. I like doing this. I always try and take the enemy forts first, because it makes the second war so much easier. I don't think Lanar is doing anything. Or Kerma. I don't think I've seen any of their troops so far. Seriously, it's only 18%. I bet, yeah, they've been chewing up my arse. Now that's what you bastards have been doing. Come on, you. I'm tempted to do that. So tempted. Okay, I'm just going to deal with them. I've got to deal with them. Which sea zone is the straits in? The straits. Okay, I think this is time we might get a piece. Oh, you're willing to do that, are you? Are you willing? How much land are you willing to give me? Okay. That would be acceptable to you. I don't think it would be acceptable to me. So I'm going to see if I can't squeeze a little bit. See, they are about to take that fort. This raises a question. Now, out of sheer interest, can you get up? Yes. Bastards. You stupid bastards, to be specific. See, I've got a good general. He's about to kick your ass. Let's go finish them off. You can deal the killing blow, Pedro. As soon as you think of that, then it'll solve my problem there. Oh, those shitloads. We have now liberated ourselves from their tyranny and their stupidity. Because frankly, they are stupid. I mean, they sort of idiot, which is attempting that what they've attempted. Beggars belief, really, doesn't it? It's like, stop! It's like, what they keep on doing is they keep on trying to attack this island, thinking, ah, it'll do something. But it doesn't, they just keep on losing. Because at the end of the day, rather than concentrate their forces, you know, and go for sort of the almighty attack, they weaken themselves by trying to sort of take tidbits. So you won't give me... No, I need that bit. Maybe if I don't demand... Yeah. Can you do that for me? Yeah? Okay, I'll... Yeah, you keep that one. And cancel subjects for 9? No. I'll send you this. So we got everything we want now. And everything's so cheap now. Look at those core costs. Like, they used to be expensive, now they're just dead cheap. And the best thing is, nobody else... You see, this is why I think I've explained this to you, but I don't... Can't remember if I actually did. That is why I got this. I went for here. Because once you've got all of South Africa, and the associated islands, you know, the surrounding islands, there's only one other way to... I'd say there's two other ways to Indonesia. Maybe three. You know, it's like... So first is obviously Africa, The second is sort of through the Suez, which will come much later on, or by taking over here. The third would be literally conquering the Middle East, all of it. And four would be coming around the arse. Which some powers are deciding to do. And Portugal is now coming around my arse. You know, they're going for all these little islands. But they're so late now that, you know, it's not going to do them much good. Nice that I've got to play Swag's album, though. So we go for some courthouses first. You will all become part of the trade. Trading company. You're already part of it, aren't you? But yeah. Okay, let's have a look what we're earning after the Spirals of War modifier goes away. It's not really a modifier, it's just a flat out bonus. Okay, we're earning that. Now, if I could give them a little bit of autonomy. Yeah. Like a bit of strategic autonomy. Around about the place, and there we go. We give them a bit more autonomy, and now they're not going to be pissed at us. Yeah, I'll go for another military edit. I'm just gonna, you know, I want to get the discipline. Because discipline's really good. So, is there anywhere? I can build some. Yeah, I'll hopefully be able to build some stuff here. Colonists will have this. Good. Next, I shall colonise New Zealand. I think Portugal's also going to colonise it in New Zealand. Brunei's done a good job in colonising them. I'll give them that. Like most of the time with unsaves, you rarely see them competently colonising anything. In fact, you rarely ever see them colonising. So it is good to see some, you know, an unsafe colonising. Because it means I don't have to do with that. Because that's half the most of the time. Bishop. You can work with that. You don't need to. Now, Ming, would you? Okay. You're just like naval strength. No. Jesus Christ, I do need to build some ships. We'll just build a shit ton of ships. Usually, I like to keep all my numbers even, but I don't care anymore. I just build ships. I'll be able to get two from there in the same time. Let's say double of us. Anyway, I'll remember them in a couple of years. Turn the speed up to full. I love this song. I don't know if you can hear the music, but it's beautiful. I'm flying over something. Very, very touching. Very, very Christmassy. I'm a big fan of Christmas. I love Christmas. I'm an atheist. I actually want to argue with one of my mates on this. See, I'm an atheist. He's a... I don't know what Adam is. I think he's a Protestant, something or other. And he had a go at me because I still love Christmas. And I'm an atheist. You know. And if you believe feminists, I'm also a misogynist and evil, evil person. Which I'm not, don't worry. No, I'm just a gaming hater. No. But I it was during Christmas time, and he basically just accused me of like Christmas for gifts. I mean, I do love the gifts. I love gifts. You know. But seriously. No. Anybody else watching? You know, what have you ever had that sort of experience with a Christian or Muslim or whatever? You know, it's... because I always find it incredibly amusing. Especially when you point out that, you know, half their festivals date back to some pagan cult at some point, you know, in the past. And they're just like, nope. But it does. I can upgrade you, can't I? I'll upgrade there. It's like, yeah, it's... you know, because at the end of the day, you know, it's incredibly hypocritical of acting Christians to criticise anybody when it comes to stealing other people's festivals or anything like that. Because at the end of the day, you know, half of the stuff they celebrate comes from pagans. You know, look at Easter. You know, used to called Ishtar. And Ishtar is obviously, she's a pagan goddess. She causes fertility. And, you know, Ishtar was a, you know, a festival for fertility. You know, what do you think those rabbits really meant? You know, that's what I've heard anyway. You see, so much I do know is Christmas. Because Jesus wasn't actually born on Christmas, he was born in September. And... didn't want to send him to Zanzibar. And yeah, so Jesus wasn't actually born during Christmas, but we're all told he was. He wasn't. Now, the Coptic Christians in Ethiopia do celebrate Christmas, from what I understand, but they celebrate it at a different time. They celebrate it in September, because that's when he was born. And the Coptic Christians are the original Christians. You know, but... thing, you know, the winter solstice, you know, winter, you know, it's always been a special time for pagans. You know, look at Krampus in Germany, you know, the pagan Santa Claus, essentially. You know, he went around giving children gifts if they were good and sticking them in a bag if they were naughty. Normal behavior. Yeah, it's bullshit half we get told in the church, it's frankly a little crap. Is there anything she's really cheap to convert? Go on, I think we'll get another one, yeah. So this is what I'm going to do now. It's going to be a strategy of colonization. Make everything Spanish. Be useful. Will you stop being shitlords? How much did you pay for this? What did you pay? How much do they cost per ship? Wait, just out of interest. 10 gold. So 100, you know, 110 would actually be about right. But they're not going to pay that. Oh, we'll do that. And now we won't spend any more money until we get the next set. Oh, more money. Perfect. Okay, and we can afford one more. We're trying to keep selling the Genoa trade now. So, what's the best option? Is it? Is there higher there? Yeah, there's higher there. Oh, actually, there's yet a better place there. Even better. So yeah, I mean, so much of, you know, Christian traditions are just what was absorbed by the pagans. That's, Protestantism hasn't really done very well, has it? If I'm being honest. Like, usually it sort of blobs a bit more. It's like, usually I see it get all over here. Usually, you know, I see it spread a bit more. It really just seems to be one area, doesn't it? With a couple of offshoots. Even the New World's relatively, well, almost completely Catholic. So's, yeah. Anyway. Let's continue. It's how religions go along, you know, you absorb the traditions of the people there in order to make it as, you know, reachable for the people as possible. You know what I mean? You know, you say, well, you don't have to change your traditions, you don't have to change your ceremony, you don't have to change this, you don't have to change that. All you've got to do is change who you worship to, you know, who you say in your prayers. You're no longer are you praying to the Morrigan, now you're praying to God to give you victory. You know, very simple, you can still celebrate Christmas, and most people will be fine with that. Most people will just sort of shrug their shoulders, go, it's better than being killed. That yellow prestige could be really useful. More useful. Yes, so. Really, you know, religious people and religion interests me greatly. Okay. What do you think we should do? I think we're going to go for more merchantism. Get us even more money from trade. Invade Puerto Rico. Oh shit, I didn't even notice that I'd completely forgotten. Oh well. Now, let's get ourselves 10,000 men. And Pedro will join this army. So this is still in the colonial region, isn't it? What trade company? Where is it? There it is. Yep, that's colonial Australia stuff. Good. I quite like Sunday, you know. Maybe I should sell them in New Zealand. Don't matter. When can I fight you again? 2 years already. Aha. This is brilliant. Perfect for my plans. I'm actually going to leave these guys over here. 4-3-3. So I just need to take 4-3-3. Okay, you go wait there. So it is. Sorry, I keep doing that. It's because it's right under the escape button. So 4. Four, I'll say it very loudly. 4-3-3. The perfect number for you. And see, the purpose of this army is going to be, once war declares, I doubt Portugal's going to have a very strong navy in this area. So I'm just going to send troops over here and I'm going to nick their islands. Because it will happen, I promise you. I will eventually have this war with Portugal that I've been wanting for a very long time. See, if I was to declare war, Austria would join. See, I want to do it. I can feel it. I'm just like, yes, I need to do it. But I'm also like, no, I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it. I'm just scared that I'll be beat by France. It's a fear of losing. See, I know that if I lose, I'll lose everything. You know, the French won't let me off. It won't be sort of like a tap me on the nose, like, oh, you were naughty. But we'll let you go this time. You know, if I lose, I will be in a great deal of trouble. You know, worst case scenario, I lose bits of mainland Iberia and my colonies on the coast, or maybe even South Africa. You know, it's very easy to get a nightmare scenario. So, I mean, in best case scenario, they just take a promise to me, like, if I can destroy their armies here. That's best case scenario. I might just bloody lose everything. I caught the Diplotech, didn't I? Yes, I'm now 14 years ahead. I'll invest a bit more money into culturally converting everybody. Because, like, all these little cultures, you know, they can become a nuisance. Yeah, so it's very simple what I'm gonna do. Well, you've already seen me sort of do it. Slowly converting some of them over to my culture. Now, this will do me a lot of good in the long run. Because it'll make them less rebellious, less miserable, less mopey, less annoying. But not until I finish this. Do you know what? My dad's been playing the game. And he was like, why was I losing? Why am I losing? Why am I losing? And I asked him to show me what his Diplotech was like. No, his military tech even, sorry. And oh my god, he actually managed to. He was in Diplotech, he was on Military Tech 22, during about, you know, like 50 years in the future. I mean, you know, everyone else was in like Tech 20, you know, 28, 29, 30. You know, good numbers. And he was just there with horrific numbers. Oh, it was horrible. Gets me cheaper ultra conversion, but it's just worth it. And you don't really need admin tech anymore. See how I'm ultra tech? There we go. Is it time? Can I now declare war again? Come on, I need war. I need more war. Yes! Bruno's like, no. Okay. I understand you, Bruno. You're just cowards. It's fine. I'm going to decrease the speed, because it would be stupid not to. So, I would usually send him to take the island, but I'm not going to. It's a little bit of a bad idea. Just dumbasses. I love the AI in this game, it can be so stupid. I think the Pasai are finally going to go extinct. You go deal with the islands. Go on, you finish. Pummel them. It must really sting to be them. Like, think about all the stuff they used to have and now don't. Burn. So you're going to go around here, and you're going to start on that one. I should probably send you, shouldn't I? Who cares? Okay, I'll send the guy with all the cannons, or the bigger army at least, Okay, you can quickly deal with this four. So once this is over, I'm going to have all of Pasai, or sort of their land. Now I don't need them. I'm not, you know what I mean? So like, I don't need to sort of like keep on attacking them in order to expand. I'm now free. I've been let loose on the continent. So like, before I only really had one way to expand. Either I would bolster my navy, or I would sort of continually, you know, fight Pasai. You see, now what, you know, it's going to be my next war against Pegu, and then I'm going to have multiple enemies so I can keep on fighting. I can keep the war machine going. Don't rest, keep on conquering poor little natives. But if you would hurry up then, send more troops. And what do you get? You guys think, should we? To reorder an assault. Do you know what? I don't care about attrition. 85,000 men versus a single fort. The attrition will be bloody huge. With the bonus. The bonus is massive! You are now self-sustaining. Good. Why am I losing so much money? Probably not a good idea to buy somebody whilst we're still losing money. Come on, finish! One more cycle should be enough. There we go. Oh, someone's knocking the door. I imagine that's Mum. I wonder if she's brought back food. If so, I may have to cut this episode short. How short am I eating? It's probably been about, what, half an hour? I don't know. What do you think I should do, guys? What do you think I do should do, Snips? I know you're not going to have to talk. Yeah, I'm going to have to make the decision alone. I say fuck no. John, I'll solve the problem. Raise war taxes. Now I'm at war with you, shitlord. You let me through your land if you know what's good for you. Oh, Pasai has another province. Didn't notice that. Listen, Karma. Like, you don't want to piss me off. They're just like, no. Like, fine. I'm just gonna find your armies and destroy them. Cause that's what I do. Pasai's like, please make peace with us. Land. Nah. Well, that's Lang Zhang. Where's Lang Na? Lana. There's a country called Lana. I will offer you a penny. I've still got this mission. Listen, I'm not gonna get coaching. Seriously. Not yet. I don't understand some of these guys. Why do you fight so much? Like, if I was Lano the Kerman, I'd have ditched Pasai long ago. Because then I know if I'm not going to fight them, then it's a point. Then it's pointless. See how much I can beat you up. Okay, I can't beat you up particularly much, but I'll take that. Now find your way to their capital. They'll capitulate just as easily. I don't understand why you keep them fighting. I don't understand why Pasai would continue to insist on keeping all this land. Like, I'm not gonna there's times where you've just gotta sort of man up and go, Joe, I've lost. And I'm gonna lose everything, my life will be destroyed. But you know what? You need to pick it up with worn out tools. Pick it up there, I can't remember what I said then. Pick it up with worn out tools, you know, like from If, the poem. Hello, Shorts. I want all your monies. And I promise you, the truth shall give in. Can we get a couple more days to get back? Come on, come on. Come on, 35 days, 20 days, 10 days, 0 days. Do you know what, I'll just wait. I am perfectly happy to just wait and I'll take everything. This will kill me, just so you know. The unrest from this will be absolutely horrendous. What's that? Overextension of 91%. Jesus Christ. Oh, but they have more money now. Come on, we'll do it. We'll take it like a man. See, luckily, because it's all colonial, it's going to take, what? 3 years. Right, well, let's brace ourselves. Quickly get rid of that military access. Jesus Christ. Seriously. Well, we'll get that. Because we're gonna. What do we need, aren't we? Actually, luckily, because of all the ideas and stuff we have, we're just sort of like. Meh. Like, you get a bit of cringe on them. I actually thought that was gonna be horrible. Turns out it wasn't, which is good. I was just thinking, like, oh crap, it's gonna be a nightmare. It's gonna be a nightmare. And it actually turned out not to be. It's amazing. It's a miracle. Okay. That one will get me up to about 160. Alright. Invest a bit of money. Now how much will I make from you? $75. Okay, and now I'm just going to go around. Bump that up a bit. Yep. Like ships, glorious ships. I need you in Valencia. Oh, pretender rebels in Sunder. No. I don't actually. These guys are gonna be from my garrison force, so they're gonna stick around on them. Indeed. Religion turns to Catholic. Perfect. I'm watching, you know. I have ambitions to become even more. Oh, they're now my protectorate. Whoa. Perfect. They're not. Don't do that. But that means that I can safely ignore them. I'm not that. Frankly, if you don't mind me putting it vulgarly, I'm not that pissed about a tiny one province minor. Because what do they produce, let's be honest? Probably grain. Yeah, I guess right. It's like if it was spices, it'd be like, okay, it's worth it. Minimal efforts for some okay games. It's still really hard. There we go. Next one's serfdom, which is good. I think this is probably a really good place to end the episode. So I have been Sammy Skull 2, and you've been watching me play EU4. I almost said Victoria 2 then. No, you've been watching me play EU4. I'll see you later.